In this video, an analysis of Alireza Firouzja with white against Wesley So with black in a Sinquefield Cup round 8. Alireza plays e4, and now we have an Italian game. He goes for d3 and c3, and this is Gioco Piano Variations. I will put a link. I have several videos on this special opening. Now, as we can see, black has played h6, so white doesn't have bishop g5, and white has played h3, so black doesn't have bishop g4. This is all natural. Now, a4 to gain some space, a5 to avoid b4. And now here, if white were to take on e6, you simply recapture with the rook, and you're perfectly fine with black. So bishop b2, what is Alireza preparing? Well, d4 and d5 is on the agenda. But here, Wesley So is a very well-known expert of this opening, has played many times against Hikaru Nakamura and Magnus Carlsen, and he strikes in the center. Bishop b5, very logical. You have a pin here. So what can black do? Take, take. And here, Wesley So starts to get the advantage with the black pieces. Knight h5. Of course, the knight is coming to f4. And if you were to try g3, bishop h3 is coming. So knight c4 played, trying to counter attack over here. Queen f6. I really like that move with the black pieces, because now, once again, you have knight f4. And if the queen were to move, you can do bishop h3 and queen g6. So in a nutshell here, black is trying to attack the white king. All of these pieces are geared toward attacking the king's side. Alireza takes. Takes. And now the first mistake. Very natural is to play queen g6, which was played in the game, attacking g2. But much stronger was to play rook ad8, pinning the knight. And after knight d4, you do queen g6, followed by bishop g4. That's much better. Anyway, in the game, queen g6 played. And here, what is the right move? Knight h4 played, attacking the queen. Queen g5. Taking here, taking there, taking here. And we can see once again that the white king is exposed here. So I like black better. And here logical was rook e5, because you attack c5 and you threaten rook g5 check. And maybe the best move is to come to the rescue here, to defend here, rook c5. And it's obvious to me that black is better. Instead, in this position, what did Wesley So decide to do is queen g5 check. Now, queen g4, obviously, white would like to exchange queens. Queen takes c5. And now, c4 played, and we're attacking here on g7. No checkmate yet, but it's not as strong for black. And here again, I was watching the game live. Rook e6 come to mind, because you're threatening rook g6. Why did Wesley So not play that? I don't know, but I think that a logical move would be queen f3, because you don't want to lose the queen. Check, and now queen g5, and I think this position is better for black, coming here and attacking here. So rook e6, maybe rook h1 was a move, but I still think that you can come here and attack, and you have a better position. So let's say I can do rook g6. That's one idea, or maybe I can take on f2, which is even better with knight g3 check. So to me, in this position, I thought that rook e6 was the way to go to continue the attack. Instead, rook ab8 is played to come here and attack on the third rank. And here, e5 played. Excellent move, because now we are cutting off the knight. And the best move for black here was to take on b3, counterattacking the b2 bishop, you come here, and this is very unclear. So you can do bishop e3, and now that knight may be captured, but essentially you're gonna give it up and at some point capture here, and you have 4 pawns extra for black against a piece you may be able to defend. And instead here, rook e6 wasn't a good move either, because you attacked the queen, and after that you just up a piece. So in this position, e5 is a very tricky move, and here g6 is played by Wesley So. And after this blunder, white is winning all the way. So what a turnaround, and what was the winning move? I'll give you a few seconds, but there was a clear winner here, and Alireza found it. The answer, bishop a3, attacking the queen moves, and now the queen is away from the king. How do you go through? e6, and this is clearly winning. Let's say if you were to take, I take, the king moves, and here rook d1, rook d7 coming. If you come here, I can do queen check, winning the knight. This is winning on the spot. Now, the other thing is like knight f6 is played, attacking the queen, queen f4, and you are attacking too many things. And if the king comes here, bishop b2, and this is game over. So clearly, white is winning, because that queen here cannot defend the king's side. So in the game, c5 was played, but now this is very easy. Queen d5, beautiful move. Attacking c5, winning the queen here, but also having a lot of ideas like queen f3, queen d7. So clearly, there's no easy way to defend. King g7 played here, and now knight f6. Now, why not move the queen? Let's say you move the queen, simply taking queen d7, picking up the rook. So here, knight f6 tried, and after taking the queen, here, black resigned. Why is that? You take another pawn, let's say the knight moves, and here you simply do check, followed by a5. The knight has to move. You're up 2 pawns, gonna do a6, a7, b4, b5, and you are completely winning this end game up 2 pawns. So here in rook e8, Wesley So resigned. A very strong performance by Alireza Firouzja, showing he's very strong in the opening. And even though he was not doing well in the middle game around here, he turned it around with the beautiful tactics, bishop a3, followed by e6, and that was enough to win the game. Very sharp in the middle game. Firouzja is definitely a top player and is in contention to win. Neptun Miachi is also in the lead, so last round will tell us the winner of the tournament. Thank you very much for watching.